Colorado Buffaloes are the champions of the North. Vivo and the Texas Longhorns, champions of the South. As we get set at Reliance Stadium in Houston for the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. The number two team in the country, perfect at 11-0, taking on the Colorado Buffaloes at 7-4 here from Reliance Stadium. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler along with Bob Greasy. It's a warm day in Houston. They have opened the roof of Reliance Stadium. And right now, Texas hoping to jump through that and go all the way to Pasadena, where they were a year ago when they won the Rose Bowl. Vince Young says, Coach, I'm going to get you back there. But to do that, they knew they had to come through his hometown of Houston. And I think Gary Barnett's got a big job on his hands today against Mack Brown.
Well, both coaches, and they're very different. Mack Brown, they've won, as you said, 18 straight. They come in sky high. His job is to settle his guys down, get his quarterback to relax and just have some fun. Easy does it. Don't get overjacked. For Gary Barnett, it's just the opposite. They come in on a two-game losing streak. They had two chances to wind up, to lock this game in. They didn't do it. They backed in. So the confidence, is it there or is it not? We're going to find out.
What's their chance today? It lies on their quarterback, doesn't it?
It does. Joe Klatt has got to play well. He is a 34-game starter. This is his 34th game. He's got to play well. But the other thing is, look for some gimmicks, some tricks, and the special teams, and they've got to get some turnovers.
For Texas, we know about Vince Young, a Heisman Trophy candidate, arguably had his best game of the season against Colorado the first time around this year.
Well, he's Gary Barnett says, I don't know where he puts his cape when he goes to bed at night.
But we know he has one.
But he has one. But he needs to relax and have a good game. I think both of these quarterbacks last week had the worst game of the year. They both were going to be rebound here today.
We talked to Vince Young before the game. He is excited. He's one of 32 Houston area players on this Texas Longhorn roster. All year long, they've been talking about getting to Houston. Well, here they are. Years coaching for Mack Brown. He's never won a conference title. He's got a chance to do it here today. Texas considered the visiting team, but they've got the home state crowd, that's for sure, and Swanee's with the head coach of the Longhorns.
Thank you, Brad. Coach, you've always said that the Big 12 championship is the number one priority. How is this team dealing with the pressure coming into this ballgame?
Lynn, I think they're so excited that we may be a little uptight early, but we told them we've been aggressive and had fun for 11 straight wins, and we're not going back off today.
Let's talk about being aggressive. Does it change because it's a championship game? Do you pull back any at all?
At Texas, every one of them are championship game, so you don't pull back at all. We're going to pull out everything we got to try to win.
Coach, good luck to you this afternoon.
Thanks, man.
Hey, I'm with Coach Gary Barnett. Coach, second time around, does this team take more risks or is it just good enough to improve?
Well, we're going to do a little bit of everything. We're just going to play better football than we did last time, that's for sure.
Okay, Coach, a moment away from kickoff. Good luck to you this afternoon.
Thank you, Lynn. Appreciate it.
Brad?
All right, fellas, thanks. Texas won the toss. They deferred. So they'll kick off, and Colorado will go back to receive. Greg Johnson's got it teed up for the Texas Longhorns. Back deep, Stephon Robinson and Terry Washington. It's a warm day in Houston. Could hit as high as 84 before the afternoon is done. The Big 12 championship is underway. Little indecision back there. Washington grabs it from Robinson. Takes it out across the 20 to about the 22-yard line. And immediately we have a few fists flying around. So Colorado will take the field, and Joel Klatt, who owns 39 records in the Colorado record books, his numbers on the season. Coming off a poor showing in the loss to Nebraska. We talked to him yesterday. He's hoping to make up for that. And he said, we've had a great week preparation-wise. We just want to go out and have some fun because nobody expects us to be able to beat the Longhorns. We'll find out in the next 3.5 hours. Buffalo's first down from the 23. Play action. Flat comes up firing into traffic, and he snuck the ball in somehow
to
Sipnewski.
How did he get that in?
I don't know. Let's check the Dr. Pepper starting lineups. And here's the big fellas up front for Colorado. O'Neill and Sanders. Fenton's an all Big 12 center. Daniels and Moore. The backs and receivers. Hugh Charles, Lawrence Vickers, Kloppenstein, Sprague, and Judge. But, of course, you'll see a lot of Sipnewski, the other tight end who had the first catch of the ball game, good for 8 yards. Second down and 2, Colorado. just inside their own 41-yard line. They put it on the ground, and they've got the first down of the ball game as Charles slips his way out to the 35-yard line where Michael Huff made the stop. Defensively for the Longhorns up front for Texas, Crowder, Ocam, Wright, and Robinson. Wright, a Lombardi candidate. Killebrew, Harris, and Bobineau are the linebackers. And in the secondary, a lot of experience. The Griffins, Michael Huff, and Terrell Brown.
Yeah, five of those defensive starters for the Longhorns are on the all-conference first team, and one is on the second team. So a very talented group defensively.
First down, Colorado from the shotgun. Flared it out. Nice catch. Fumbled out of bounds, but it's a catch for Kloppenstein. And a pickup of five. Cedric Griffin pushed him out of bounds. Check the game plan, Bob.
Well, Colorado offensively, Klatt needs to lead the way. As Klatt goes, so goes the Colorado Buffalo. And defensively, pressure the quarterback. They know they have to get it. Every coach that we talk to for the Longhorns says, we got to get pressure on Klatt.
Patrick Williams comes in as an extra wide receiver here on a second down. Last year's coach of the year, Gary Barnett in the Big 12. This year's coach of the year in the Big 12, Mack Brown on the other sideline. Second down and seven. They bunch three receivers to the right, and then they pitch it that way to Charles, who cuts it up across the 40 in a tough run. Out to the 46-yard line, and another Colorado first down. What a great start for the Buffalo.
I was just going to say, I like what I'm seeing from the Colorado offense. Throwing on first down, shifting, maneuvering on this play. Three guys on the outside, all cracking back. A guard pulls and kicks out. Charles is a guy that can make some big plays from the running back position.
That's about the way you draw that one up. First down in Texas territory. Play action. Klatt again goes to his tight end, Sipnewski this time, and he's got it down to the 37-yard line. And not only is Kloppenstein an all-Big 12 performer, but Sipnewski had the first catch of the ball game and this one here. And, Bob, I know you and I were at practice in the walkthrough yesterday. There's a lot of NFL guys that like both those tight ends.
Well, it's great. If you're a defensive coordinator, you look at this offense. They've got two all-Big 12 tight ends. They've got Sipnewski, the backup, who is a sixth-year senior. He's 6'7" and 265. And one of the scouts I was talking to talked about Sipnewski before he talked about Kloppenstein.
Second down and three. Flat, quick throw out in the flats. Got his man. It's Hugh Charles. And the ball's loose. Texas has got it, but are they going to say that he was down? Oh, the Longhorns take over.
Well, the line judge was right there, and he didn't say anything. So in his mind, his view, the ball came out before he hit the ground.
Robinson recovered. Let's take another look. He's trying to get control of it. It did come out
and
before he went
right
down. Michael Huff made the hit. Watch the ball come out before his knees go down. It's already out right there. So Texas gets a break on the fumble recovery.
That's the fourth forced fumble for Michael Huff this year, along with a bunch of other big plays that he's made for that defense.
Another all-conference performer, and so a good drive for Gary Barnett's Buffaloes. Backfires right there. Vince Young comes up throwing, completes it out. Line is Swede, and he's got it into Colorado territory. A first down, a throw of 16 yards to the Buffalo's 49-yard line. Vince Young played a lot of his games over at the old Astrodome right next door when he was playing in the high school playoffs. He's a high school legend around here, much like the basketball playgrounds of New York. That's what he's considered in this town from a football standpoint. And he's home, and he's had a hard time getting enough tickets. First down, Romance Taylor. And he picks up a couple. As we take a look at the Dr. Pepper starting lineups, up front, the big eaters for the Horns, Scotts and all-conference, Studdard and Sendline, and Allen and Blaylock, both are two. The backs and receivers, Taylor, Hall is the fullback, Thomas a good tight end as well, Cosby and Swede, the wideouts. There's three wide receivers in right now, and Vince Young goes out to one of them, and that's Cosby, and he's got a first down for Texas. So both teams have started quickly, and both teams are using the pass to kind of light things up here in the first 4 minutes. Defensively for Colorado, here's how they look. Wright, Anapuna, Gary, and Lucas. The linebackers look like this. Washington, Iwu, and Dawn gets a start because he's from this area. Sims and Burl on the corners. Billingsley and Hubbard are the safeties. On first down, Vince Young, quarterback draw, broke one tackle, got away. Young on his way inside the 30. Stiff arms his way down inside the 20-yard line. And Texas in the Colorado red zone here in the first minutes of the ball game. 18-yard run by Vince Young.
Colorado is going to blitz this situation. They're going to blitz. And when he gets in there, he's going to get a hold of his leg right here, Washington, but just can't bring him down. That'll drive a coach nuts when you get a guy in your grasp, negative play, and he turns it into a big game.
At the 19-yard line, a give to Taylor. Taylor's got a convoy in front of him. Colorado does a nice job, though, to spread it out and cut in behind to make the tackle. Maurice Lucas, the freshman defensive end, made the stop. Check the game plan for Texas offensively.
Well, Vince, just relax and have some fun. He was sky high coming into this game from being from this area. And defensively, you need some turnovers to win. Unfortunately for Colorado, they turned it over offensively on this on their opening drive.
Second down and 8. Young from the shotgun. Plenty of time in the pocket. Now he'll take off. Nice move inside the 15. Cuts outside. Might have a touchdown. Will he get there? Not quite. 16 more yards, though, and it's first and goal.
How do you defend this? Mike Hankowitz, the defensive coordinator, gets a good pass rush and gets good coverage downfield. But then when Young starts running, he is so big and shifty, as he just goes into another level of ability and talent.
There's his rushing yardage on the season. First and goal for Texas. They bring in the big fella, Henry Melton. The freshman is the tailback in the eye. He'll get the call. And he's in. Touchdown, Texas. Just like that. 6-0 Longhorns. Certainly has to be a little demoralizing for Colorado that they had such a great drive of their own going. They fumble it, and they watch Vince Young just take it right down the field, and Texas is in the end zone already.
Well, that's the problem in this game between these two teams. To win, Colorado almost has to play a perfect game. They can't make those mistakes.
David Pino's in for the point after. 7-0 Texas in the Big 12 championship game. Vince Young had runs of 18 and 16 yards on the opening drive. Mack Brown told us, we're going to turn him loose in his hometown. Let him relax and have fun. I'd say he's having fun. Johnson to kick. Let's see who takes this one. Last time, Washington took it away from Robinson. This time it's too deep, and Stephon will have to take a knee in the end zone. They'll start from the 20-yard line. Dusty Sprague, the motion man. Stretch play to Charles. And he took a big hit as he got about 2 yards, and Michael Griffin came over and let him have it. Griffin, the safety, number 27, had 23 tackles in the win over Texas A&M. In fact, he had 14 tackles, a forced fumble, a fumble recovery, and a blocked punt against Texas Tech. That was considered one of his best games, but 23 tackles for a defensive back's a lot of hits.
That is, and he is the leading tackler on that defense, as you might imagine.
Second down and 8 for the Buffalo. Maybe a blitz coming, and here it comes. Platt knows it's coming, and he got it flared out, and he did a good job. It's incomplete, intended for Lawrence Vickers, who's upset with himself and drop-kicked the football out of bounds.
Now, Vickers has got to make that play. We mentioned that, you know, Colorado has almost got to play a perfect game. Klatt does. He sees it coming. He buys some time, gets rid of the ball. Now, all Vickers has got to do is catch it.
Couldn't have thrown a better pass under that much pressure.
It's a little bit behind him, but Vickers can catch that ball, and you can see that he knew that he should have caught it.
Well, Lawrence had 24 catches coming into the game. We saw him have a tremendous ball game against Missouri earlier this year, and he had 4 touchdowns. 3rd and 8. Platt with all day to throw. Bounced it off Offenstein, who probably should have had that one as well, but Michael Huff made the hit from behind. So Colorado's got a punt.
Well, that's not the recipe that the Buffs wanted going into this game. First drive, fumble. Second drive, three and out. Now, they are going to try some they're going to gamble. They're going to try some tricks and some gadget plays and whatever, but I don't think you're going to see anything backed up this far.
Not at their own 22-yard line, you wouldn't expect. Yeah. John Torp, who's a Ray Guy finalist, is set to punt inside his own 10-yard line. Aaron Ross waiting on the other end for Texas.
Yeah, they've got two of the best kickers, Colorado, but Aaron Ross has taken a couple back for touchdowns already this year.
He's got a shot at this one from the 42, spun away. Somehow got through about three would-be tacklers and got to the 48-yard line. So great field position. Only a 36-yard kick as Torp didn't hit it nearly as well as he normally does. 6-yard return, and Texas with a touchdown lead and excellent field position. At least 9 wins in each of the last 10 years for this Longhorn team. 11-0 coming into this one, and they get it to the 50-yard line. This is the first time Texas has been 11-0 since 1983.
When's the last time they were 12-0?
Never.
There you go.
I don't think I'd have known that, except Mac told us that down on the field before the game. He said the folks in Texas are excited because they've never been 12-0.
He was trying to settle everybody down, and he was trying to settle us down.
I guess so.
Mac was a little nervous, too, which is understandable.
Option pitch, Jamal Charles on his way. First down, Longhorns. He rips off 18 yards. Colorado coming in at the number 2 rush defense in the country, and they're getting gashed right now by both the quarterbacks and the tailbacks for Texas.
Well, it's because Texas has the number 3 rushing offense in the country, and they've got talent at every position. Charles is a true freshman and doesn't get to play a lot. Well, he plays about half the time because Ramon Taylor, he shares time with him.
First down at the 17. Quarterback draw for Young. This time they have him wrapped up after only about a yard gain. Akarika Dawn, the middle linebacker, made the stop. Going back to his high school days playing at Madison High School in Houston, if you go up to now as a starting quarterback, he's 62-8. That's not bad.
See, not bad at all.
He's 28-2 as the Longhorns.
Yeah, and they have not huddled. They just go back up to the line of scrimmage. Vince looks over to the sideline, gets the play.
Charles takes it down to the 15, where it's going to bring up a third down and a long 2, maybe 3.
Well, Texas doesn't do this a lot. I think Max said they were going to do this to start the game just so you're not in the huddle, calling a play, breaking the huddle. Just get up, and you're standing around. Just relax you a little bit.
He said he thought that maybe his troops wouldn't have to think so much about the magnitude of the game they're in. They could just go out and play.
Right.
And that's what they're doing, and they're doing a good job of it. Third and 3. Charles looking for his blockers, and he fights his way to the 5. First and goal, Texas. Boy, it wasn't there at first, but he just kept hiding behind those big eaters. And then he found a little crease and busted it down to the 5-yard line. That offensive line's a dandy. Scott and Stuttered, the Centline, Allen and Blaylock.
I think you mentioned 3 of them were all conference, and 3 of them are coming back. In fact, 8 of the 11 starters on offense are back if Vince comes back, as he says he's going to.
He reiterated again this week that he's coming back for his senior season. The scary thing is this might be a better football team next year if he comes back. Third and goal. Young. Throws complete, touchdown, Jamal Charles. His 24th touchdown pass of the year, a short one but effective, as Charles out of the backfield has made it 13-0 Texas.
That was too easy, Brad.
Sure was.
Talking to the Colorado coaches earlier in the week, they said, you know, we didn't challenge them. Everything was too easy for them. We're going to have to make it tougher for them. Well, that was one of those on the easy side.
Dino in for the point after. As with less than 6 minutes remaining, Texas has jumped out to a 2-touchdown lead, as a lot of people thought they would be able to today. They're almost perfect so far. 14-0, Longhorns. Texas has run 15 plays, 12 of them have been in Colorado territory, and they lead 14-0 already. I mentioned the highest scoring team in the country at 49 a game, over 40 in 10 of their 11. The only missing one there, their win in Columbus over Ohio State.
You know who the second highest scoring team in the country is?
I think they're playing next, aren't they?
USC, yeah. Yes.
So that one was a 52-yard drive in just 8 plays. Greg Johnson's kick. This one should be returnable for Stephon Robinson from the 1. And only out to about the 17-yard line.
They're out in front, where they should be.
Flat on first down. Throws a strike complete. Evan Judge, and Judge is out across the 40 to the 41-yard line. Evan Judge, one of the main offensive weapons, number 2 receiver as far as number of catches on this team. Charles, he can get to the corner, could have a big gainer, and he does, down the sideline. And he's out to the 40-yard line of Texas. Colorado, their offense in gear again. They'll run a little option here. Platt will keep it, and Platt broke into the clear and got banged out of bounds at about the 24-yard line. Joel's not a bad runner, but you don't expect to see him rip off 16 yards. They had run 6 straight times on the drive. They're going to run again, and it's Platt again, and Joel puts both hands around the football and goes down to the original line of scrimmage. We talked to him yesterday, and he's quite a competitor, and he knows that the game against Nebraska, he said, you know, I don't know why we thought we could be overconfident, but I felt like that's the way the team felt, and shame on us. And he said, tomorrow, we're just going to go out and play as hard every snap as we can, and at the end of 3.5 hours, then we'll look up at the scoreboard. That's not a bad way to approach it.
That's the right way to approach it. I think that game against Nebraska last week, they were still in a daze from the week before against Iowa State, losing that one. Single coverage at the bottom of the screen, blitz up the middle.
Here comes the blitz. Flat rolls away from it. Sets and goes to the end zone. It's almost intercepted. It was intended for Dusty Sprague, and Aaron Ross broke it up.
Yeah.
And there is a penalty marker on the play.
Yeah, he threw that ball way too slow, too easy.
Oh, another holding call.
Yeah.
Man. So that'll bring out Mason Crosby, the guy that Swanee talked about earlier. And this is chip shot material for him. 20 out of 26 on the year. And inside of 40 yards, he's only missed once ever. 22 out of 23. This is a 31-yard field goal attempt to try to put Colorado on the board.
45.
Nick Holtz will hold. And it's blocked. Ross trying to find the handle. Texas has blocked it. Aaron Ross now. And he's got help going the other way. He's got the corner. They're going to bring it back anyway. It's going to be an illegal block on the blocked field goal return, but Texas has it back.
That's the 42nd block in the last 6 years. They lead the nation blocking punts the last 6 years. Blocking punts and kicks, field goals, extra points.
Well, that
right
one came in the middle, and that was Robinson. Brian Robinson got up in the air.
That's what makes this Texas team so difficult. Offensively, they're good. Defensively, they're good. And special teams, they lead the nation, as I said, in block kicks. They're in the top 10 in punt returns and in kickoff returns.
You're going to see the illegal block right there, and it was against the kicker, Crosby, as Ross took it out near the 25-yard line. They bring it back, and the line of scrimmage will be the 6. Robinson, a defensive lineman, but they say he can dunk a basketball standing still. You saw his vertical jump right there. You see Vince Young at his own goal line on 3rd down and 11 from the end zone. Got pressure. Incomplete. It's intercepted. Picked off by Colorado going the other way. They're going to have it first and goal at the 5. It's Tom Hubbard, the safety on the ricochet, a 22-yard run back on the interception return.
That's what this Colorado team needs, is something to ignite it. Everything that's happened so far has been negative. They've had 2 turnovers, 1 turnover and a blocked field goal attempt. That's the first one positive thing in their favor.
The ricochet came off Swede, who had a hand on it.
Here's the tip, and there's the interception.
Now can Colorado capitalize with a touchdown? We talked about chip shot field goals. That didn't prove to come to pass either. So now let's see if they can get a score, trailing by 14. Charles, the tailback in the eye. Vickers is in there with him. They give it off to Charles. Spins in the hole and loses yardage. I think one of these Colorado backs pretty soon better put his head down and go forward instead of dancing around in what is a collapsing pocket. The quarter is going to come to a close. We'll switch ends. We'll see if the Buffaloes can score in the sunshine on the other end of Reliance Stadium. First quarter belongs to the Horns. Three quarters away from a trip to Pasadena. They lead 14 to nothing. Joel Klatt trying to take advantage of it. Second and goal for the Buffaloes at the 8-yard line. Klatt, quick drop, looks right, now left, and throws incomplete. Intended for Kloppenstein. And it was Michael Griffin who was shaken up earlier in the ballgame that made the play defensively from his safety spot.
Yeah, nobody open. Pumped to the right side and came back to the left. Those tight ends are his biggest targets. Kloppenstein is 6'6", Sabnewski is 6'7".
And it's third down and goal, Colorado.
Klatt has been good inside the 20 in his career. 24 touchdowns and only two interceptions. His motto is touchdown or check down.
We'll see if he can get the touchdown here. Blitz might be coming from the Horns. Here they come. Flat. The fade to the corner. Patrick Williams was the intended receiver, but he was nowhere near the football.
They couldn't get away from the defender. Yeah, and that's what he's upset about. He thought he got held. Williams is just a redshirt freshman and a guy that they think is going to catch a lot of passes in Colorado. He's the one that they want to get the ball to, a big play guy. Take a look right here. That's Ross on the left side in the white jersey.
I think he might have had something to complain about.
Yeah, I do too, because the ball was in the air. When the ball's in the air, you can't block him or put your hands on him.
Robinson got the last kick blocked. Crosby's got this one up and good. So they get three. You know that they wanted seven out of that interception return that got them to the 5-yard line. They'll have to settle for a field goal. But the Buffaloes on the board of the Big 12 championship here in Houston. It's 14-3 Longhorns. Second-ranked Texas trying to punch a ticket to Pasadena in a national championship matchup in the Rose Bowl. They lead 14-3 here early in the second quarter. Ramontz Taylor takes a kick from 2 yards deep, and he's got a big opening on the left side. Taylor across the 40, all the way out to midfield and into Colorado territory. Boy, that thing just opened up like the Red Sea over there. I don't know where the coverage was from Colorado.
The coverage went to the one side of the field where all of his... Look over here. He's supposed to run over here, and that's where all the white shirts are. He knows that also, so he cuts back, and all the Colorado guys went where the white shirts were.
Well, Bob Brown, this is the kickoff return version of the naked bootleg.
Yeah.
Where you just run away, and everybody is going to where they should habitually, and he's doing something else.
You got enough speed, you can do that, because you're on your own.
Longest kick return allowed by Colorado all year. 54-yarder. Now it's Young to his tight end. David Thomas has got another Longhorn first down. So in two plays, they're down to the Colorado 32-yard line. Let's take a look at the Dr. Pepper first quarter statistics. The rushing yards relatively even. And the total yardage actually in Colorado's favor. But the turnovers took them in bad spots and gave Texas an opportunity for a short field. They took advantage of it both times with touchdowns. Colorado didn't. They only got a field goal. Young now the option keeper. And Vince goes down. As Washington made the play, and there's penalty markers all over the place.
I think it was a late hit on Douglas.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 91 on the defense. Half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down.
It's a true freshman that they think highly of at defensive end. Take another look. There's Lucas, 91. Young is down, and Lucas is hopping on top.
Oh, boy, that's
not very smart.
That's flagrant, almost.
At the 14-yard line, Texas has taken it the length of the field in a hurry, leading 14-3. Young from the gun gives it off to Taylor. And Taylor's dropped, actually, for a loss of one. Lucas made that play, as a matter of fact.
Just thinking of what you just said, and it's just, you're so true, in a hurry.
Texas offensively just moves down the field so effortlessly.
They're gliding right now.
They glide. And that's what Vince Young looks like. When he throws it, it's an easy effort. And when he runs, it's just like he's gliding. He never seems to have a negative play. Well, they catch him behind the line of scrimmage.
They caught Taylor behind the line of scrimmage for a yard loss, so it's second and 11.
No.
Quick throw out. Got it out. Got a good block. First and goal down at the two-yard line is Quan Cosby. Well, they set that up beautifully. Had two guys out there, and his other receiver threw him a block. And they've got it down at the two-yard line.
Crosby's on the outside. It's just a wide receiver screen.
Watch Billy Pittman's block, number five.
Right here.
Boom. Perfect. It's the way you draw it up. Blocks like Swanee.
Oh, wait a minute.
Extra tight ends. Thomas is one of them. He's in motion. Third and goal. Play action. Young has to scramble. He's in trouble. Cuts inside. Dives. He's in. Touchdown. What a run. There was a lot of traffic lights there, and he weaved his way through all of them.
It's like having 13 guys on your offense.
So he's thrown for one and he's run for one. The first time against Colorado this year, he ran for two, ran for three, and threw for two. He's on that same kind of pace right now.
The Buffs had everybody covered. Everybody covered. Then they had Vince covered when he started to run. Then they still had him covered. And then finally he found a hole.
David Pino in for the point after. Texas dominating Colorado here in the first half. Vince Young, he's something special to watch. As Bob said, never looks like he's in a hurry. Never loses yardage on a play. Always finds a way. This time he found a way 2 yards to the end zone. He is massive to stand next to him as we did in the warm-ups. I just looked at Bob and I still can't believe how big he is. This isn't the first time we've seen him this year. On the kick return, Stephon Robinson has a nice run back. Gets it out to about the 33-yard line. Colorado actually will return some of their tickets, so this is a burnt orange crowd. Even though Colorado is considered the home team wearing the black jerseys, Texas considered the visitors in their road whites. But it's all Texas in here right now, and it's all Texas 21-0, and it could get worse. Intercepted by Terrell Brown. He's out to the 30-yard line. Texas has it right back. Just like that, one play, and Texas with the interception and a 12-yard return.
Brown makes a nice play. He sees what they're trying to do and comes off. Watch Brown here. They're trying to hit the receiver going to the outside. Brown sees what's going on. And then comes back right there. See where he comes back?
Yep.
He says, I'm not going to bite on that cheese that you're throwing up or near the line of scrimmage. That's just good coaching.
He saw the cheese and he ratted out Joel Klatt at the 31-yard line. Play action. Vince Young might want it all on the first play. Going deep. Got his man. Sweet. Touchdown. Perfectly thrown. Swede used that big body to keep the defender off him at the goal line and brought it in for another Texas touchdown.
That was Burrow, the same guy we were talking about. 5'10", 160, going up against Swede, who is 6'4". 6'5", maybe.
6'5".
Yeah.
Nino's been a busy place kicker. Another extra point upcoming. Texas leads Colorado 28-3, and we still have 11 and a half minutes to go in the first half. A smiling Mack Brown knows he's that much closer to a shot at a national championship. First things first, the conference crown is at hand, and they are making it look easy. And everything Texas is dialing up has been exactly the way they've drawn it up. Stephon Robinson from the five. Robinson got some blocking on the far side, and a flag goes down. It'll negate a nice return again. Let's check in with Lynn.
Well, a lot of great athletes at the University of Texas, and this is a football game, but I've got Roger Clemens, one of the great pitchers of all time. Roger, you were in the locker room before this game began, and you had to get a sense of this football team. What was it like in there?
Well, they're relaxed and they're focused, and, you know, I love to listen to Coach Mack talk, you know, and hear what he has to say to the kids. But, hey, they're great athletes out there, and they're well coached, just like you said, and we're looking for a collision, I think, what is it, January 4th?
Well, yeah, collision. Talking about that collision. But before we talk about that, a lot of people want to know if you're going to come back and pitch one more year.
Yeah.
A lot of people in the stands are chanting one more year for you.
Well, I tell you, man, I love coming home to play, and there's a lot of energy around this city right now. So I can tell you, I only tell you, I really enjoyed it. And, you know, it's fun for me to be able to come back home and then get out here and attend a, you know, an event like this and have Texas come here and play in Houston. It looks like a home game. All you're going to see is nothing but burnt orange here today.
Well, you know, I'm from Pittsburgh, and I'm sure I could, if they allowed me, give you a piece of paper. We just fill in the numbers. You come pitch for us.
Well, you know what? I don't know how to dance around that question. I danced around the last one. I'm just enjoying the offseason. My body's healing. You know about that. You played through a lot of pain in your career, and you know, I'm just real thankful, feel very blessed, Isaiah, to come home and play a couple years.
But isn't it the respect of the fans? I mean, they were chanting you to come back, and you were just saying you'd have to go 2-11 for them not to want you to come back because they enjoy your competition on the field. And so every year you've got to make a decision, what, based on how you feel, family, where your competitive edge is?
That's absolutely right. It's definitely how I feel, and can I compete? Can I compete against, you know, kids half my age, you know? And you're always trying to stay healthy, and you know, it's just the energy. The energy we had baseball-wise here in Houston was unbelievable the last few years. And I think when you know when you come down to an event like this, that's what you hear from these people.
Well, I know the Texas football players are always happy when they see great stars from the past come back. Guys are still active. They respect you. So thanks for coming.
Bunch
back.
Of good kids. Thank you.
You're welcome.
One of the all-time greats in any sport. And he did do a nice job dancing around that loaded question, didn't he?
He's done that before.
Yeah, I think so. Plant in trouble. Joel trying to throw a screen and got it to Hugh Charles. And he only got about 4 yards, and they're going to have to give it up again. Punting time, and it's going to give Texas great field position again. John Torp will have to come out to punt. Near his own goal line when he feels this snap.
Joel Klatt just trying to make something happen. Sometimes you just can't do it by yourself.
Joel Klatt's gone 10 quarters now without a touchdown pass. He hasn't thrown one since we saw him a few weeks ago. Torp to punt. His first one wasn't very impressive. This one's an end-over-end job, too, that Ross is going to have a shot at from the 45. Ross got a great block. Well, I guess not. I guess we're going to call a legal block. I thought that one was clean as a whistle, but it's coming back. Third straight start now for Vince Young and the Longhorns offense in Colorado territory. When you say that, you're in for a long, long day. Young, two touchdown passes already, and he's lofting one for three deep again, and he's got it at the 5-yard line. This is just too easy right now.
Defensive back, Washington lost sight of the ball. That was Henderson. Lost sight of the ball.
And again, Sweet is 6'5". Watch him go up.
Look at that. Henderson doesn't see the ball. And if he would, Henderson is 5'10 and 175. These defensive backs for Colorado are on their smallest side, to say the least.
First and goal, Vince Young is looking the other way and throws to the end zone. Thomas, touchdown, Texas. What a catch by Thomas, the tight end. He's one of the best around as well. David Thomas, who passed Pat Fitzgerald on the all-time tight end reception list in Texas football history, has got his 15th career score. And he'll stay in there to help block for the extra point by David Pino. Yard drive in just four plays, and it took less than 2 minutes again as Vince Young has thrown another touchdown pass. 35-3 Texas. Deep kick won't be returned by Robinson. Gary Barnett, though he has done a great job being the North champion for the last 5 years, they're in a buzzsaw right now. It's a pitch. Charles does a nice job trying to run away from the pursuit by Texas, which got there in a hurry, picked up about 4 yards. Robert Killebrew, sophomore out of Spring, Texas, made the stop.
This is not one of those situations, Brad, where Mac Brown wants to really run it up. I mean, he wants to win the game, but, you know, he's got a good friend on the other side of the field. In fact, Gary Barnett told us earlier in the week, he says, that my best friend in coaching will probably be on the other side of that field in Mac Brown.
Yep. Ellis, the tailback. Platt's going to flare it out there, too, and Roderick Wright giving chase. Boy, that just shows you how fast the defensive linemen for Texas are. Larry Dibbles and Roderick Wright almost beat that pass out to the tailback.
Yep. We mentioned when Mac was at North Carolina that, you know, he said in going to Texas, he says, staying at North Carolina, it's tough to win a conference title.
Right.
But going to Texas, you might be able to win a national title. And if Texas wins today,
they're in the big game.
This will be the eighth time in the last 12 years that a Big 12 or a Big 8 school has either won the national championship or played in the title game.
Pass is tipped at the line. Incomplete. It'll bring up fourth down. Here comes a punt. Corp finally got a hold of one. Hit it up in the rafters, and it's fielded at about the 29-yard line by Aaron Ross. Young from the shotgun. Fakes it and throws a pass out complete at the 43-yard line. Nice catch. Lima Swede and Young on one knee holding his elbow a little bit. Thaddeus Washington came on the blitz.
He kind of whips this ball, doesn't step into it. He gets hit just as he's throwing it.
And he took a helmet right on the elbow. And you just hope that that's one of those crazy bone situations you can shake off. And he's still rubbing it.
I mean, he threw that ball about 35 yards to the sideline.
Just zipped it.
And didn't even step into it.
No gain on that play by Ramon Taylor.
That does point out probably the only weakness and the biggest weakness on this entire Texas team, and that is the depth at quarterback.
Right.
If anything should happen to Vince, Norgram, number 7 right there, Matt Norgram is the backup, and he has not played much at all. I think he's like 4 of 9 and one interception on the year.
We saw him play a little bit in the game against Kansas when the game got out of hand. Matt got in because that was the final home game at Royal Memorial Stadium in Austin, so he got a shot to play in that one. But you're right, they don't want anything to happen to number 10, that's
all,
for sure.
All the other good quarterbacks on the roster are redshirting and haven't played.
Reminder, near the conclusion of our game today, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Vince in the shotgun again on first down. Gives it off to Charles. Charles trying to take it wide. He somehow eked out about 2 yards on the near sideline on the gain. James Gary made the tackle, pushes him out of bounds with 1:08 remaining. Vince is going to throw again, maybe. He'll throw short this time across the middle. Salvin Young makes the catch at about the 23-yard line. And we're under 1 minute to play in the quarter. It's going to bring up third down and about 2. Clock winding down near the 42nd mark. 35-3 Texas. And here's Salvin Young. First down and a lot more inside the 10. Young's got it first and goal. Down near the 4-yard line. You know, there are people saying, why is Texas trying to score? They've got such a commanding lead. You can't put a guy like Salvin Young in, who's a Houston native as well, and say, you know what, take a knee. He's trying to get to the end zone, and he almost did.
They have so much depth at running back. Salvin Young was the starter last year before he got hurt. They have Romance Taylor, who has been outstanding, and then Jamal Charles is a true freshman. We asked Mac, I said, well, how do you get all these freshmen to come and play when they have all these other freshmen coming? He said, we'll just play them all.
And he has.
They want to play. Everybody gets to play.
On the option, Young the pitch, Charles to the pylon. Did he get there? He did. Touchdown, Texas. Jamal Charles with a 2-yard touchdown run. Well, he caught a 2-yard touchdown pass earlier, and now he heads to the corner and tiptoes by.
His feet got in, but did the ball ever cross the pylon?
Pino in for the point after the kick is perfect. And Texas has been almost that perfect. Let's check in with Swanee.
Well, Coach, you've got a big lead. I'm sure there's nothing you yell at your team for. What do you say to them in the locker room?
Well, Len, the thing we talk about is great first half. Colorado's got a lot of pride. Gary Barnett's a great coach. Keep playing.
Okay, Coach, I want you to take a look at the monitor here. Vince Young, he's going back for a pass. Looks like he hurts his elbow a little bit. What goes through your mind there?
Nothing. He's a tough young man. He's playing hard, and I'm proud of him.
Well, one of the things you have to consider would be injuries in the second half. Obviously, you want them to play well. Would that impact your decision on who plays in the second half?
Lynn, the most important thing to Vince and this football team is that we continue to win, we get this game over with, and we're the Big 12 champions. Then we'll start thinking about injuries. This thing's far from over. You've been around this business long enough, and I have to, about the time we start talking about somebody else's business. They get hot and come back. We got the ball to start the second half. We need to drive and score and keep the pressure on them and keep the momentum. Hard to get to this point. We're not going to let up right now.
All right, Coach. Keep coaching them out, Mac.
As your Big 12 Coach of the Year, he's coaching like it today, isn't he? 42-3 at halftime. Texas in front as we go to John Saunders. So I don't know what Gary Barnett might have come up with at halftime for his Buffaloes, but they'll be on defense first because Ramonce Taylor takes the kickoff at the 1-yard line. And he had a 54-yard return earlier, and he's going to do a nice job to get this out across the 30 and out to about the 32. Let's check in with Swanee.
Well, you're wondering when Coach Barnett told the team at halftime. He said, look, Texas played championship football in the first half. Now we have to go out in the second half, and we have to play championship football. I asked him if there was anything specific he could do to kind of change what they had done in the first half. He says, look, we're not going to panic. We had some good drives. We turned the ball over. We made some mistakes, but we can move the ball. So we're going to go out there. We're not going to play two-minute offense. We're going to go out and play our game plan to execute, not panic.
See how they do on defense. Vince Young comes up throwing, and he's got a man. Oh, what a hit. Cosby made the catch, and then Lorenzo Sims let him have it, but he held on. 17-yard pass play.
Now, you may feel that tomorrow, and maybe it's some ribs or something, but you got to bust the heel if you're going to a championship game.
Ooh.
Good concentration and a good hit.
Billingsley comes in and puts the shoulder to him.
Yeah, Billingsley may be small, but he delivers a big hit.
So Texas and Ramonce Taylor are going left, and they're back in Colorado territory already. So as Bob said, 30 of the 39 plays in the first half. Now they're two plays more, and they're right back in Colorado territory. Our Pacific Life game summary statistically in the first half, 282 total yards. Almost exactly twice as much as Colorado was able to muster. The field position was all in Texas' favor, as we mentioned, and two touchdowns off turnover.
Yeah, the two turnovers that Colorado gave up scored on both of them.
Taylor's going to be short of the first down by a couple. He'll bring up third down at about two. As you might have seen when Swanee was talking to Mac Brown going to the locker room at halftime, he said, you know, they're a proud team, and Gary's a good coach, and we're going to come out and try to score the first possession of the third quarter. So here they come again.
And, you know, what else can you do? I mean, it's a football game. You got to play the rest of the game. You want to go out and try and score.
Here's a quarterback draw. Young's got the first and more. Vince doesn't go down until he gets to the 29-yard line. Brian Iwu made the stop, but another 14-yard run by Vince Young now.
And you can't play scared. You can't say, oh, don't run, Vince. Just take care of yourself. He's back in his hometown. He's 5 miles from where he grew up. He wants to play. He played all of his high school games next door in the Astrodome. He wants to come over here and play and have some fun.
And he is. He's got 57 yards on the ground now. A touchdown on the ground, three in the air. Ramonce Taylor. Vince just kind of got out of his way, gave the inside move, let him go by him, and Ramos has a nice gain. Got it down to the 23-yard line, inside the 23.
One of the problems for Vince Young is, in a blowout game like this, is, you know, how long are you going to play, and do you really need to throw for touchdowns? I mean, if he's trying to impress some voters out there with a Heisman ballot, you know, in a game like this, you know, where the game is already over for the most part, you know, what are you going to do?
Taylor cuts in, cuts back out, and gets back to the line of scrimmage. That's about it, Lynn.
Well, Bob and Brett, we have to remember the Kansas game when we covered Texas, and they had a 52-0 lead at the end of the first half. And Matt Brown said it's always been his position that he would play Young at the start of the second half, see how he goes, but at least put him back in the ball game for that first drive. And then after that first drive, he'll see what he should do next. Keep in mind, this is a Big 12 championship game. There are a lot of seniors on this team. He's probably going to give them a chance to play should they maintain this big lead throughout the ballgame.
And right now, there's Matt Norgren, the backup. Vince Young is 14 of 17, throwing the football. Salvin Young's got a first down, got a blocker in front of him, puts his head down and bowls his way down to the 4-yard line. His first and goal, Texas again. Young had a run much like that in the second quarter, and he goes down and he gets to about the same spot.
Yeah, you know, the offensive line, you know, these guys, we don't talk about them enough. From left to right, Scott and Stuttered and Senline, Allen and Blaylock, Garcia is in there some of the time. They've got six guys that play pretty regularly, and maybe the other guy.
Salvin Young just walked in for the touchdown. 4-yard score. And they're right about on their average point-wise. If they hit the extra point, they will be. So the opening drive of the third quarter is a Texas touchdown.
Well, they've had the ball eight times today, and they've scored on seven possessions. But they've had, the only one they didn't score on was an interception, and that ball was tipped.
So Pino in for the point after the cap, a 68-yard opening third quarter march for the Longhorns. And it's up and good. Right on their average, 49-3. Vince Young did much of it. Salvin Young had a couple of chunks. The flat score was good for a touchdown. Young and Texas leading Colorado 49-3. Another scoring drive just completed by the Longhorns, 68 yards and 8 plays to open up the third quarter. Johnson's kick. He fielded right at the goal line by Terry Washington. Washington got by the first man. Got out near the 20-yard line. Ryan Palmer made the stop.
Two turnovers and a missed field goal. A field goal block, excuse me.
Flat comes out to Vickers. Complete across the 20. Only got a couple of yards on the play. Michael Huff made the stop. Talked a lot about Vince Young today and his numbers. And at the end of the game against Texas A&M last week, he was a little dejected as he headed up to the locker room. Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, was with him. He was kind of hanging his head, and Mac Brown ran up to him and he said, "You know what the important numbers are, Vince? 11-0, you're 28-2, and we're going to Houston. And today he'll become 29-2, and that will break the Texas record for victories by a quarterback." That should have been the Aflac trivia question, by the way. And Bob, I know you know who that is. High pass, incomplete, intended for Alvin Barnett. Bobby Lane holds the Texas record with 28. Vince Young also has tied it with 28 today. Will become 29-2 as a starting quarterback. That's pretty impressive.
And it is. And the scary thought is he's just a fourth-year junior. He's a redshirt junior and says he's coming back and playing. You know, it's like a man among boys.
Yep.
He's not only the tallest, but he's the best.
He might get up there around 40-some victories if he comes back. Third and long. Flat to throw, lobbing it, and almost picked off. Tipped Michael Griffin got a hand on it. And Colorado has to give it up. So three and out is not what the Buffaloes were looking for. Joe Flatt was looking for some kind of holding or interference call against Evan Judge again and didn't get it.
I think sometimes they need to get him out of the pocket. They did that early in the ball game, and that worked pretty well for Buffaloes.
John Torp to punt. The left footer standing inside his 10-yard line.
Look out.
Oh, he took too long. Oh, blocked. God. Touchdown, Texas. Griffin and Foster were there. Oh, I think Griffin blocked it.
I don't think Foster
covered it.
Yeah, I don't think it took too long. I think it was the protection up the middle.
That is the sixth blocked kick in Michael Griffin's career. He's already the record holder, and he's just adding to it. And I remember thinking in the first half, Bob, watching Torp punt, he takes too long, and watch how long he took here.
Right up the middle. Torp takes a while, but when these guys come right up the middle.
Fifth block punt, sixth block kick of Griffin's career, and then it's covered by Brandon Foster for the touchdown. What else can go wrong for Colorado? Pino in for the point after. Texas 56, Colorado 3. They're doing it in every form and fashion in the burnt orange and white today. This one, the special teams, with another touchdown.
If there's a weakness in anybody's protection on punts, on field goals, they'll find it. And Texas has blocked a field goal, and they have blocked a punt here today.
Let's see if Colorado can muster more than a three and out here. Charles on a toss. And he bounces it outside, and Charles takes it out for about 7 yards as we take it out and check in with back in gear. Coach Johnson there, the Bobby Dodd Coach of the Year last year with Navy. Commander-in-Chief trophy on the line in that one. Here, the Big 12 Conference Championship on the line, and Joel Flatt trying to pitch it. I think Texas got to the ball before it slid out of bounds. They did. Nope, I take it back. Third down.
Clatt trying to run the option again. Get
Robinson
rid of it.
Gets him.
He is not experienced at running this. He needs to get the ball before Robinson.
Ooh.
Yeah, looks like he may have had possession before he touched out of bounds.
The replay official has ruled that Texas possessed the ball in the field of play. The ball replaced on the 26-yard line, Texas.
Even the reviews are going into the burnt orange category.
It's interesting the way the different conferences announce. He announced the replay official has determined.
That's right. not that he has to worry in this stadium because there's not many Colorado fans here. But
no. The replay official has determined that the Texas man had possession.
So Brown with the fumble recovery after an interception earlier. And Texas takes over at the Colorado 26-yard line. It's Young still in there. Hands it off to Paul Charles. Charles broke a tackle and another on his way to the end zone. Touchdown, Texas. Yards for Jamal Charles, and the Longhorns add to their lead 62-3. And this is the third time they've scored over 60 points this year. And there's a couple of happy guys.
Yeah, you know, and as many happy guys you see on the other side, there's a whole different story on the other side of the field.
Is that ever the truth? Pino in for the point after. A 60-point lead for Texas. 26 yards in 8 seconds. One play after the fumble recovery. Colorado, only four teams have gone over 100 yards. Texas 183 already. We got a long way to go.
I think Barnett has done a great job in the last couple of years of holding his team together from what they've gone through.
Right now, with a 63-3 advantage over their northern rivals from Boulder.
And a fumble. Texas has got it at Griffin.
Just when you want to ask the question, what else can go wrong for Colorado, you get the answer too quickly.
There's Colorado, for the most part, and most of the season, Charles is going to cough this one up. You got to take care of the football.
Aaron Harris, I think, locked his arm around there.
You just have to, for the most part, in coming into this ball game, Colorado had given up the ball the least times in the Big 12, but they had increasingly given it up in turnovers the last couple of games, and now it's just continued in this ball game here today.
Matt Nordgren is in at quarterback. Vince Young's day is done, as unlatched, a big smile on his face, 193 in the air, three touchdowns, 57 yards and a touchdown on the ground. And that 14 out of 17, you figure, can he even be any better than that? Well, the first time these two teams met, he was 25 of 29 for 336 yards and a couple of touchdowns. As Bob said earlier, Gary Barnett said, I don't know where he keeps his cape at night, but I know he's got one, and that's the way he played again today. And did he help his Heisman Trophy candidacy? I don't think there's any doubt about it.
You know, if you're wondering, there's approximately 15% of the ballots have already been cast.
Right.
So there's a bunch of them out there.
About 923 voters are West Midwest, Mid Atlantic, and Northeast.
Yeah, 923. This is the sections.
52 former Heisman winners, one fan, and Bob and Lynn and I are part of that. Ramont Taylor still bouncing around down there and got down to the 10-yard line. Now, I think a lot of people wait for this championship Saturday to make their selections, because you never know what kind of game somebody's going to have. And Vince, who had one down game probably all year, and it was the A&M game last week, and he has skyrocketed back up the charts, I'm sure, in a lot of people's opinions. Just inside the 10-yard line, a third down and a long three. Here's the toss. Taylor behind his blockers. Ramont stretches it out, trying to find that first down marker, and he might have gotten it. Boy, he had a wall in front of him, and he just ran behind it until he could find the sideline. He knew exactly where that first down marker was.
Pick your poison. You know, do you want to run it, or do you want to throw it, or we can block your field goal, we can block your punt, we can return kicks, we can return punts, we can play defense. You know, there's no doubt that this is going to be a great representative in the national championship game.
Taylor to the corner, trying to stretch out. Ryan Walters brings him down, but he got down to about the 2-yard line. And here's a quarterback draw a la Vince Young. Nordgren. Down just before the goal line.
You know, that is always a good play inside the 10 in a pass-run situation. Even if the guy is not a good runner, it's a good play. Any quarterback can drop back like this and run straight ahead. You got a guy like Vince Young running this, and the chances of scoring are triple. Offensive line blocking up front.
Now they bring in Melton and Hall. Third down and goal from about the 1-foot line. It's Melton. And it's in for the touchdown. I think, looking up at that scoreboard, I don't know if either team wants to see any more of this. 70-3 if the extra point's good.
That's what turnovers will do for you. Colorado has had four turnovers and two kicks blocked.
Henry Melton, the freshman, has four rushes for 1 yard and two touchdowns. They didn't need much.
Yeah.
Tito in for the point after. Good. Everybody in the act offensively, everybody in the act defensively, and on special teams on all cylinders. It's Texas 70-3. Greg Johnson will kick. He's done a nice job pinning the Colorado return man, and he will again. This one goes out of the end zone.
And a great job that Carl Durrell has done at UCLA, being the stepsister, the little sister, out there for the last few years in the city of Los Angeles.
James Cox run out of bounds on the run, and Joel Klatt there helping him to the locker room. Let's check in with Lynn.
Well, boys, just to confirm what you were speculating, he did have his bell rung. You see, he's still wobbly, walking off the field. In other words, the doctor said he had a concussion. They're helping him up right there. Now, the locker room is actually the opposite direction of the tunnel they're walking up now. That end of the tunnel, there is an x-ray room. Keep in mind, he did take a shot, the helmet to the jaw. They're probably just going to, they may take a precautionary x-ray. But other than the fact that he's a little wobbly and that whole thing, they're not going to speculate on the severity of the injury. Brett?
All right, Swanee, thanks. And Joel, we'll wish you the best in not only recovering, but we've enjoyed watching you play. We know it's done for today. And
he's got one game left.
Well, he's got a bowl game left, yep. But we won't see it in person. But
no,
we'll wish him well.
Good kid.
Yep.
Bright, smart kid. A lot of fun to talk to.
Time permitting, reminder to stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. John and Craig and Aaron will have all the scores and highlights from around the country. Roses are red, the Pacific is blue. The USC streak ends at two. That's pretty good.
That is good. I like that one.
Put a little thought into that one.
Uh-huh. The burnt orange with the caps.
Cox back to throw, getting some pressure, and he takes a big hit. Almost had the pass picked off by Brandon Foster, who would have taken it in for a touchdown, but it was Robert Killebrew. Man, he looked like Harmon Killebrew on that hit. Watch the shot that he gives James Cox after the pass is delivered. Texas is still playing at 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, well, you're exactly right, and that's fine. They can do that. One thing that I have often said, and you've heard me say this over the years, is that the NFL does a better job of protecting their quarterbacks than the colleges do. And these guys are amateur student athletes.
Tarp. His punt fielded. And across the 40, Aaron Ross. So Bob's got his projected guesses, and he has number one and number two in the Rose Bowl. And Virginia Tech playing tonight in the ACC Championship against Florida State. He's got them in the with Penn State in the Orange Bowl. We'll go back to that after this play. Toss sweep from Melton. The big fella, almost as big as his blockers, and bouncing off guys and almost got a first down run out of it. He's a load.
He is a load. And he's just a true freshman amongst all those other guys.
We might have to wait on our VCS guesses until the fourth quarter. The third quarter's come to a close.
Good stuff.
The suspense builds about Bob's VCS bowl projections. I don't know if the officials don't know that the third quarter's over. We assume it is when it says 00 up there. I think they finally got the message. It's 70-3, Texas. Our presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our ABC station. Now, just 15 minutes separates the Longhorns from Pasadena. An honor to be young in California on January 4th on ABC Sports. That's where Texas is headed after this fourth quarter is concluded. They lead 70-3 as we enter the fourth and final stanza with Bob Greasy and Lynn Swann and some of the youngsters from Texas. I'm Brad Nessler. The Dr. Pepper Big 12 championship game, and it is going to be Texas to have and to hold in the next 15 minutes. We make so much of the Vince Youngs and and Jamal Charles and Ramon Taylor, and Mac has told us, you know, this is a team that anybody that gets their hands on the ball, be it offense or defense or special teams, can take it to the end zone. And they've showed us that today. And I think you sometimes forget, Bob mentioned it earlier, just the dominance of their offensive line. Those guys up front are something else. And the defensive line's just as good. And that's where it all starts. And you can have all the flashy guys in the world. If those big hosses up there don't get the job done, you're going to be in for a long day. But they are deep, and they are talented, and they're big.
And they have 16 of the 22 starters are back next year. I mean, we did the national championship game with USC in the Orange Bowl last year,
yep.
And they had a lot of players coming back. Texas has just as many this year. They're going on to play for a national championship. And if Vince Young comes back, along with these other 16 starters,
wow,
Texas will have as good a chance of repeating if they win it this year as USC did.
A rare third down coming up for Texas as they try to use as much clock as possible to get this over with without anybody else getting hurt and without doing any further damage on the scoreboard. Talking about the relationship between Mac Brown and Gary Barnett. And Mac this week called Pete Carroll and left him a message and said, Pete, I do not know how you've done this 33 times. I've done it 18, and I can't almost believe that, because we did the last Texas loss. It was way back in the regular season last year, and now Texas, with the second longest winning streak in the country, will have 19 straight wins. And Texas, of course, USC sitting on 33 with their date with UCLA coming up shortly. Oh, they've got the USC sign, but it's to tell them what's coming. Well, we'll have to wait and see. Richmond McGee has gotten a little work in the second half. He had the easiest job in the country for three quarters, without having to punt. Last time they ran into him, and that gave Texas another first down. And now he's waiting for that play clock to go down as far as he possibly can before punting away. Matt Melton down there. What's the stop on Robinson? Let's talk about who's hot and who's not, Bob.
Well, this is for the season. This is where the team started. This column over here is where they started. This is over here where they finished up. Penn State made a huge leap. So did Notre Dame and Oregon. UCLA was 27th to 12th. TCU, Alabama, Boston College. Central Florida was 114th. And they moved up. They weren't ranked, but they were ranked 114th at the beginning of the year and had a nice record.
James Cox, and another penalty flag flies in. As I said, if you see him, you got to call him, even with 1:57 left in a 67-point game.
Yeah, that's right.
Eric Jackson is going to be the guilty party of a pass interference call against Dusty Sprague. So those were your hots, and I agree with all of those. Do you have some who's nots?
It's never fun to do the who's nots.
Pass interference, number 13 on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. Automatic. First down.
I don't think there's any question that the biggest who's hot not team this year was Tennessee, mm-hmm. being ranked second in the preseason. Oklahoma finished up at 7-4. Michigan had a little off year. They were ranked 8th and ended up 7-4. Florida State, my alma mater, A&M, was ranked in the top 15 and ended up 5-6. Those are some of the teams that weren't so hot this year.
And, of course, several of those are going bowling, too, but they're not going to the bowl that these guys are going to. And
that's true.
The party is starting on the Texas sideline. So some of that freedom that Mac Brown's given them, even in pregame warm-ups and during stretching before practice, he lets them do a little dancing if they want to dance. And they say that the one guy that can't seem to stand still, whether it's practice or a game on the sideline or in the huddle, is Vince Young. James Cox throws incomplete here in the final minute.
You know, this is a great moment for these players to have been at the Rose Bowl and beat Michigan in a great comeback. I think that win really set the tone for this season. Then the second game of the year, they went to Ohio State and validated that win over a Big Ten team, Michigan, by beating Ohio State on a Saturday night on national television. And then continuing their great season this year by winning over Oklahoma,
right,
winning the big game that they hadn't been able to win. And now they get to this point and they realize they've won the Big 12, they've got a shot at winning a national championship for the first time in a long time around here.
You know what? And let's congratulate Mack Brown. 22 years a head coach, 168 victories it'll be right now. This will be his first conference championship ever. And he gets the bucket as well.
Well,
a double bucket.
One guy goes up and hugs him. One player hugs him like, hey, coach, thanks for all the good stuff.
Uh-huh.
They just hold him so he doesn't run away.
It's a sneak attack. Play action. Cox going. Got a man open, and Vickers and overshot him. There's 17 seconds remaining. Mack Brown's burnt orange is wet orange. On the Texas sideline, there is nothing left to drink over there. He got two more buckets during our timeout. There might be some drinking in Austin tonight, though, I guess. There's your conference champions of the Big 12, Vince Young and the Texas Longhorns. Our congratulations to them. And we wish them well in Pasadena when they play for the national championship. Mack Brown and his wife Sally and the rest of the Longhorn family, good luck out in Pasadena. Let's go down to Lynn Swann.
Well, Coach Brown, one question, 22 years, congratulations, Big 12 championship, and what will be a trip to the Rose Bowl to play for the national championship. How does it feel?
Lynn, it feels great. It's great for these fans. What a great moment today. Great for these kids and these assistant coaches, and really the 2001 team that lost in this game started all this, because they were the first ones to win 11, then we won 11, then we won 10, 11, and now we're going back to the Rose Bowl.
What does it mean to these senior players to have battled with you, stayed with you all this time to get to the Rose Bowl again?
Well, it means a whole lot. It's a dream to ever play in the Rose Bowl. You did that, and that's something not many people get to do. And it's another dream to get to go back 2 years in a row. A lot of people said when we left last year, we're coming back. And, you know, you think, well, we got a lot of work to do, and now we are.
Vince Young said last year he was coming back to the Rose Bowl. You said when you took this job at Texas, you would have a chance not just to win the conference champion, but the national championship. And you're only about a month away, Coach.
Well, we are. The guys have gotten their goal. Now they're working on a dream.
Okay, Coach. Congratulations.
Thanks.